And Mr. Frost's first breed is the English Setter. The English Setter was at work as a bird dog in England well over 400 years ago.
Congratulations.
The Setter's job in the field is to locate quarry, stand frozen in place while the hunter shoots over him. This is a breed of exceptional beauty and style, as you can see.
Down and back.
English Setter.
Thank you.
Gordon Setter. The Gordon Setter is a product of Scotland named after the Duke of Gordon. They were developed in the late 1700s and are one of the most historically interesting breeds. The first Gordons were imported by a dog fancier called Daniel Webster.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
See you, Spide. Thank you.
The Gordon Setter. Irish Setter. The Irish Setter was first developed in Ireland in the 19th century. He was brought to this country as a gun dog, but his happy nature and good looks soon made him popular in the show ring, and also as a companion animal of enormous high style.
Sweetie, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Yes, please.
Irish Setter.
Thank you.
Irish Red and White Setter. Despite its name, the Irish Red and White Setter is a distinct breed, not just a different colored version of the Irish Setter that you saw. Bred primarily in the field, they are strong, powerful, and athletic, with a keen and intelligent attitude.
Congratulations. See his bite. Lovely.
Irish Red and White Setter. The pointer. The pointer is one of the oldest sporting breeds. The first dependable reference to the breed appeared in England about 1650. As his name implies, the pointer points with his nose. He searches for game using his highly developed sense of smell, and having found it, freezes into that classical point.
Just see his bite. Thank you.
Pointer.
Thank you.
German short-haired pointer. The German short-haired pointer with his white feet is a retriever on land and water. He was developed in Germany and Austria in the 19th century. He is easily trained and is an exceptionally fine all-round hunting dog.
See you, bye. Thank you.
German short-haired pointer. The Weimaraner was developed in Germany late the last century. Originally, it was used on large game like wolves and even bears. He is a fine family companion as well as a splendid sporting dog afield. By the way, the first Weimaraners were brought to the United States by the GIs when they returned from World War II.
Let's see about.
Weimaraner.
Stay.
Wiesla. This is far and away Hungary's most famous hunting dog. His background is almost certainly hound and some Transylvania pointing dog. He was not really known in this country also until World War II.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Wiesla. Brittany. The Brittany, as his name implies, originated in France how many centuries ago is not known. He was considered the world's only pointing spaniel until a number of years ago when the word spaniel was dropped from his name. This is a versatile dog in the field like most gun dogs and works well as a retriever.
Lovely, thank you.
Brittany. German wire hair pointer. The development of the German wire hair pointer began around 1870. This is a rugged hunter that can work any kind of terrain. He's vigorous, intelligent, and most happy when he's working.
Thank you.
German wire hair pointer. Wire hair pointing Griffon. This is a breed from the Netherlands that has become popular with French and German sportsmen. He has two jobs. He points and then retrieves the game. He's an excellent nose and is a powerful swimmer. By the way, his records go back to Philadelphia at this show to 1887.
To see her back. Lovely.
Wire hair pointing Griffon. The Barbet. The Barbet is a friendly, bright, and sweet-natured French sporting dog. He is strong and solidly built, bred for centuries to be a keen hunter and tireless swimmer.
Just see his pipe. Lovely. Thank you.
Legato Romagnolo. This is an ancient Italian water retrieving dog. He's been transformed into the world's foremost truffle hunter, folks. He searches the Italian forest for truffles buried deep in the ground.
Congratulations.
Agile in both mind and body, this dog has the endurance to work all day.
See his bike. Lovely.
Legato Romagnolo. Spinoni Italiano. The Spinoni Italiano is one of the oldest varieties of Griffons in existence. The Spinoni's ancestors in Italy trace back to 500 BC.
Congratulations.
He is a fairly close-ranging hunting companion and has an excellent nose. The Spinoni is by nature a wonderful land and water retriever as well. Spinoni Italiano.
Thank you.
And folks, say hello to the Bravo Italiano. This is the American Kennel Club's newest breed to be accepted. The Bravo Italiano dates back to the 4th century BC, making it quite likely the oldest pointer in the world. It is gentle in the home and tireless in the field. Tough and intelligent, docile and easy to train. Welcome, Bravo Italiano.
Yeah, welcome. Thank you.
Bravo Italiano. Flat-coated retriever. This breed was developed in England about a century ago and is generally accepted that the most foundation spot came from American breeds. This is a very efficient water dog and is also
flat
used with
don't
success
know that
in upland shooting.
Just see his bite. Thank you.
Flat-coated retriever.
Thank you.
curly-coated retriever. They arrived here from England in 1907. They're exceptionally powerful in the water and outstanding sportsmen. His coat should be distinctly curly, living up to its name.
Congratulations. See her back. Yeah, just about.
Curly-coated retriever. Golden Retriever was developed from the flat-coated retriever and the Green Spaniel. The Golden's drive and pace, his keen sense of smell, soft mouth, and eye style all reflect generations of his sporting dog. Still widely used in the field, the breed has become one of the most popular dogs of all time.
See his bite. Thank you.
Golden Retriever. Like the Golden, the Labrador is now one of the main breeds used for leading the blind and working with other assistant dog capacities, such as search and rescue. Labrador.
Thank you.
And here's the dog with the longest name. It is the Nova Scotia Duck Tolling Retriever. It's Nova Scotia's greatest gift to America since smoked salmon. They are the smallest of the retrievers developed in the early 19th century. He is alert, determined, and quick with a keen desire to work and please.
This is my... Thank you. Oh, it's...
Yep.
There we go.
Nova Scotia Duck Tolling Retriever. The Niederlandse Korker Hundja. This is an old breed from the Netherlands dating back to the Renaissance. They were used primarily for duck trapping. Folks, there's only about 9,000 of this breed worldwide.
Congratulations.
Chesapeake Bay Retriever. The history of the Chesapeake can be traced back to 1807. They are known for their hardy nature and love for icy waters. Folks, if you're a control freak, don't own one of these beauties, as they possess a streak of independence and their relationship with humans as a equal partnership. Chesapeake Bay Retriever. Irish Water Spaniel. The Irish Water Spaniel is one of the oldest water spaniel breeds. It was imported from Ireland 10 years before the American Civil War and was one of the first breeds recognized by the Kennel Club of Philadelphia.
Congratulations.
He is the tallest of all spaniels. Irish Water Spaniel.
Thank you.
The American Water Spaniel. This breed originated in the American Midwest and is one of the few American originals of the dog world.
Congratulations.
In the field, the American Water Spaniel
I know.
All kinds of birds, as well as rabbits, and is equally at home on land or water.
We're probably not going to make the broadcast now.
Of course, this is a Boykin Spaniel, not an American Water Spaniel. Yes.
Folks, this is the Boykin Spaniel.
Yay! Congratulations
Thank
as well.
You so much.
Boykin Spaniel.
Thank you.
English Springer Spaniel. The name Springer comes from the work this dog does in the field, rushes or springs its game. He was the rootstock from which most other Spaniels we know today were derived. He is a fine all-around field hand and choice companion animal.
Thank you.
English Springer Spaniel. And here is the Welsh Springer Spaniel. The Welsh Springer is relatively rare in this country, but traces back to Wales and the West England for centuries. He has always been thought of as a splendid showman as well as a good, reliable field dog. He'll work in almost any climate, by the way, folks. The Field Spaniel. The somewhat rare Field Spaniel was once classified as a form of Cocker Spaniel, but was eventually set apart as a separate breed.
Congratulations.
He is a useful and handsome spaniel and highly effective in the field.
Just see how bad. Thank you. Yes, please. Down to the marker.
Field Spaniel. And here comes the Clumber Spaniel. The Clumber Spaniel is another product of England. He is characteristically a slow, deliberate worker of field, but is always dependable. He's one of the oldest recognized breeds in this country, dating back to 1883.
Congratulations.
Clumber Spaniel. the Sussex Spaniel. This breed gets its name from the county of Sussex in England, where it almost certainly originated as one of the oldest distinct spaniels. He has a cheerful and affectionate nature, as demonstrated by his almost constantly wagging tail. And there goes that tail. The English Cocker is a descendant of the original English Spaniel reported in the journals in the late 1300s. As the American version of the Cocker gained popularity, it became necessary to define the English as a group apart. By the way, this was done in 1946. English Cocker Spaniel. Cocker Spaniel. The Cocker has evolved in America as the smallest of the sporting breeds. He was developed from the English Cocker, seen here first in the 1800s. In fact, the two breeds were separated by Geraldine Rockefeller Dodge of Morrison Essex fame in the 40s. The Cocker Spaniel is divided into three color varieties: black, party color, or ASCOV. The last stands for any solid color other than black. And this is the Ascot, any solid color other than black.
Thank you.
Ascot, Cocker Spaniel. This is the party color cocker.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
see his part. Thank you.
Party colored cocker.
Good boy, I
can. Thank you, sir.
And this, of course, is the Black Cocker Spaniel.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Let's bring out the Irish setup, please. Wonderful. The Spinoni. And the Bracco. Labrador. Spinoni. And the Cocker. Thank you, guys.
Golden.
Just go behind the sign. We're going to go around one at a time. Just stop and free stack at the far end, and then to the end of the line. We're going to go one at a time. Pardon? Yeah, free stack at the far end. Thank you. 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 I'd like to say congratulations to the breeders, the owners and the handlers. Wonderful group. First, the Irish Water Spaniel. Second, the English Springer Spaniel. Third, the Cocker Spaniel. Fourth, the Nova Scotia Duck Calling Retriever.
Okay, folks, give it up for those beautiful sporting dogs.